The digital miter angle readout is there. It is, you can see it's marked here. It's a backlight is there. It's a LCD display which shows what angle you are at. It's very convenient, and it can be adjusted as point one, like 1/10 of a degree. And you can adjust. There's a lever here. You can move left or to the right. You can see the preset points. Like if I start from the zero, now it's at zero. Go to the left, it shows minus. It's minus 15, minus 22.5, minus 31.6, and minus 45. It goes all the way up to minus 55, but there is no detent there. If you go to the right, minus means left. It goes to the right, it locks at the same way, 15, 22.5, 31.6, 45, and 60 degrees. At 60 degrees to the right, there is a detent. At 55, there is no detent they have given, because it can go only all the way to up to 55 to the left. But it can be adjusted to 0.1, that is so 1/10 of a degree. And those adjustments can be done from the detent places. If you push this to the towards the miter saw, there is a ring here. If you press, you can it'll go. You can see it goes 0.1 adjustments, like 2.1. It goes from 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, like that. Increments of 1/10 of the degree it goes. That's a very good adjustment, fine adjustment. Sometimes we have to make. These fine adjustments, we can override with this. The detent override is here. You can move it with that. And another feature is that there is a, they are given a light switch here. You can see the light is coming. This is, I believe it's LED lights. They started with automotive kind of bulb. But I think 2011 onwards, they changed it to LED lights, and which lighting the both sides of the blade. There is light actually. It illuminates the work area. You can see, I'll show, it's a wooden piece here. You can see on both sides, it's highlighted. So you can exactly, you know, where the cut is going to be. It's very useful. I didn't have in the other Dewalt. It's very good. Some people think it is not LED. I think this white color is LED. The other one, the yellowish color, it was showing before 2011 model. That model is discontinued. That is using automobile bulbs. It's electronic soft start. It's very easy. Before you cut, you can sneak and see where the cut is going to be. Without damaging the material, you can do that. That's a very good thing. And another feature this has is that it's a electronic control circuit which gives constant speed for the blade. Whether there is a load or there is no load, the blade gets the constant speed, which is a very good thing. Another thing I want to talk about is a dust channel. There is a dust channel. I actually removed the dust channel for adjusting the bevel angle. It comes on either side, two plastic pieces comes, and there's a chute. It goes down, it collects 75% of the dust. Unfortunately, this did not come square. I had to make some adjustments here to square the table, and also the bevel adjustment. It's, I went through the material. It's so confusing. It's very poorly written, as many people have mentioned. It's my operating manual is very poorly written, especially I feel the areas where you have to make the adjustments to see that the blade is square, the table is square to the benches, bench to the blade, and the table to the blade are all square, so that you can have a perfect bevel angle and perfect miter angle. The document is poorly written. There is a bevel adjustment is there behind. There is a lever here, I'll try to show that. It's a paddle lever. This is the paddle lever. I'll show you. There's a paddle lever here. This is the paddle lever I'm talking about. It goes up three positions, it goes all the way down. That means it is locked. This position, you can change it goes to the preset places. And all the way up, you can make the bevel adjustments. This is for the bevel adjustment lever. You can make the changes. Middle position is for it's a paddle kind of thing, and it goes all the way down, it is locked. Which is a very good thing when you are operating the blade, you can, from the front itself, you can go and make the adjustments here, which is a very useful feature. And there is actually electric brake for the blade. To stop the blade very fast, like when you compare with other miter saws, this stops faster than the other blades, which is easy, so that you can take your workpiece out of the blade easily, and it fasten your work, speed up your work. This another thing I love is that there is a motor here, the motor Milwaukee has given. It is a direct drive, there is no belt given like other models like Dewalt I had. It had a motor hanging here, the side. So when you have the bevel cutting, it was touching the plate, I had to remove the plate to have the bevel cutting. This gives a better balancing, better handling and life to the motor also, because it's a direct drive, the other belt will wear off after some time. And there is a dual sliding, the tubes are given, steel tubes are given, horizontal steel rails, and they are very large, and they are on the bearings. It's a very smooth slide. Milwaukee also has improved hands. They are given so many places where you can lift the miter saw. This is one handle. They are given one here on either side. Both sides of the table they have given for you to easily handle the saw. And there is one actually behind also. Just behind the saw there is a big handle. So it's very easily you can manage. You can move around. Though it's very difficult for one person can manage, but it's, you know, that the weight I was talking about is 65 pounds. If you can move around 65 pounds, it's not a big deal. But for me, I can, but I don't want to break my back. Always, if I get help, I try to get help to load into the truck or put in on the miter stand. So that's what I do. Some people say it comes out of the box with 100% accuracy. For me, it was not. I measured this angle. This is not 90 degree. I had to make some adjustments to the blade, to the bench, and also the bevel. I have to make some adjustments. I couldn't make now. I'll be making, because that's so confusing. The manual is so confusing. One thing, as I mentioned earlier, this left fence slides, the right one do not slide. We have to lift it off. If you have to make, you have to put something, or you have to do a bevel cut, big angle, you have to take it off. That's something Milwaukee has to look into. I hope they will do it in the future models also. The RPM is actually 3200 RPM for the motor, and the blade is 12 inch diameter. Yeah, the blade there separate is it's okay. You can do most of the work with that. Mostly, if we are doing the crown molding, maybe better with the 80 teeth. This, I think, it's a 60 teeth they have given. I have to do crown molding, so 60 teeth they have given. So it's not good for fine cuttings. Otherwise, chopping or other things, it's okay for making duck, etc. This is fine. But crown molding and other fine things, I prefer 80 or above one. Or some to make some fine furniture. That is what I prefer. So most of the things are covered, and then I have to mount. Yeah, there is one more thing. Yeah, there is one thing here. You can make the depth adjustment of the cut here. Can adjust what depth you want. Actually, there is a plate here which you move into and make the adjustment. You remove the power, and then you can adjust your blade according to what height you want. And there is a lever on top. It's like a screw. You can tighten with your hand, and so it will touch the plate here and it will stop there. So if you want to cancel that, move away the plate, and then it will go all the way back like a chop blade. You can use it. And as I mentioned earlier, this there's a guard here actually, but one of the negative points is that you can see through. Generally, you can see through the work, but when you are actually working on a wood or anything like that, it's so difficult because there is no slots or a perforation on this guard, so that you can through see the work where the blade is touching. What I do is that I lift it with my hand when I am doing it, then I have a look at it on the side of the blade, then I lower the guard. So that is something Milwaukee hopefully will work on their next model. That's it. I believe most of the things I covered, and I am going to mount on the table they have, the stand they have given, and I'll come up with more reviews. Bye now.